I'm going to do the calendar trick with you today, which is a bit of an old mathematician's trick. If you give me a date, I can tell you which day of the week it is. I'm hoping to teach you how it's done as well. Okay, well, I've got the book of calendars, goes back to 1800, goes up to 2100.
Let's do June 18.
All right, okay, so...
1976.
All right, June 18, 1976. So I'm going to think about this, think about the year first. So 1976, and June you said? And what was the date?
18.
18, is it a Friday?
I don't know.
Let's find out. This is tension now.
June 18. Yes, it is.
Oh, wow, I'm so glad that worked. I tried to look confident, but I'm really glad that worked. Yes, you could test me again to prove that I really know what I'm doing.
January 1, 1901.
Going down, so the year 1901, and you're saying January 1, is it a Tuesday?
I don't know. Tuesday.
Oh, wow, wowee. So I think it's time that I taught you how to do this. So it's a calculation. I haven't memorized every calendar in that book, by the way. It's nice to tell people you have, but I haven't. There's more than one way of doing this, but I'm going to show you something called the Doomsday method, which was devised by our friend John Conway in the 1970s. And to do this, you need to memorize some special dates. The 4th of the 4th, by which I mean 4th of April, 6th of the 6th, so 6th of June, 8th of the 8th, 8th of August, 10th of the 10th, 10th of October, and 12th of the 12th, 12th of December. And what is quite cool is all these dates are on the same day of the week. And it's a nice fact, isn't it?
I didn't know that.
I know, it's a lovely little fact. Just keep that in your pocket, yeah. So that special day of the week, we call that the Doomsday, because that's going to be special for what we're going to do next. In fact, there's more. I can show you some other special dates. The 9th of the 5th, the 5th of the 9th, the 7th of the 11th, the 11th of the 7th also share the same day of the week as all those. Doomsday will change every year, but I know that these dates are all sharing the same day of the week. So for example, if I know that the 4th of April is a Monday, then I know that all of these dates are going to be a Monday for that year. Oh, by the way, nice way to remember some of these. I mean, these even ones are quite nice to remember. These ones, I work 9 to 5 at the 7-Eleven. That's sort of a way to remember it. I haven't talked about January, February, and March. Slightly trickier because of the leap year problem. For January, the special date is the 3rd, or it's a 4th on a leap year. So to remember that, it's the 3rd of January for 3 years, and then it's a 4th on the 4th year. For February, it's the last day of February, which is 28th normally, but 29th on a leap year. These dates will share the same day of the week as all my other special dates. I've only left out March, and so for March, the special date for you to remember is the 14th of March, or as mathematicians like to call it, Pi Day. Pi Day is Doomsday. So if you know the day of the week, if you happen to know the day of the week for Pi Day, you will know all these special dates for the rest of the year. Now, if the date you want to know is not one of these special dates, well, you just adjust. So all I have to do is find the nearest special date, and then I add or subtract a few days. One thing to remember when you're doing that is if you add 7 days, you end up back to where you started. So if it was a Monday and I add 7 days, I get back to a Monday again. If I had to add 15 days, then I might add 14, which takes me back to Monday again, and then I add one more. Well, shall we do a date in the future?
Yeah.
What do you want? 20th of
Christmas.
Christmas, lovely. Christmas. Let's talk about Christmas in 2021. Now, I happen to know that Pi Day in 2021 was a Sunday. So I know it's a Sunday. I now find the closest date. Where's that? Well, it's going to be the 12th of the 12th. So I know the 12th of the 12th was a Sunday as well. But I need to add on 13 days. I add 7, takes me back to Sunday. And I add 6 more days, takes me to Saturday. So I now know that Christmas in 2021 is a Saturday. So that's kind of nice as a kind of a life hack. If you happen to know what Pi Day is for that year, you can work out all the days of the week for the rest of the year. And that's kind of a nice little fact to have in your pocket. Of course, if you really want to be impressive about this, then you want to be able to do this for any year that you're given. But that involves working out what Pi Day is or Doomsday is for that year. So let me show you how to do that. Okay, if you want to work out Doomsday for some year in the future, let's do that, then one thing you need to remember is Doomsday for the year 2000. And I will just tell you this as a fact, in the year 2000, Doomsday, you can call it Pi Day or whatever you want, was a Tuesday. In 2001, our special day was a Wednesday. In 2002, our special day was a Thursday. In 2003, it was a Friday. In 2004, our special day, it was a Sunday. And then if I keep going, like 2005 is a Monday, and so on. Hopefully you can see what's going on. So every year goes forwards one day, and a leap year, it goes forwards an extra day. So if I want to work out Doomsday for a year in the future, then what I do, I know 2000 was a Tuesday. I then just add on the year, because I'm adding as many days as the year, and then I add on how many leap years we've got as well. And that's the calculation I'll be doing in my head. So if I do an example.
2020.
Okay, so if I do 2020, so I know 2000 started on a Tuesday, you actually add on the years, the 20 years, and then I have to add on how many leap years, which means I take the year and divide by four. If I divide by four here, I'm gonna get a 5. Don't care about the fractions, you can throw those away. But in this case, there weren't any fractions. So I'm gonna start with Tuesday, add 25 days. So what's that going to be? I don't care about sevens. So I don't care about 21, they can just disappear. And I would have 4 left over. So it's gonna be Tuesday plus 4 more days. So I know Doomsday in 2020 is a Saturday. If I then want to work out a date in 2020, I then just do the Doomsday method and find a special date and adjust from there. And that's all there is to, well, I say that's all there is to it. That's the calculation I'm doing in my head. You can do this calculation. You get better at it with practice. And I can actually show you some sort of tips and tricks so that you can get really good at this. Okay, tips and tricks. One is to convert the days of the week into numbers, because then it just turns the calculation into a sum. So I'm not thinking, oh, Tuesday plus 25 days. It just becomes a regular sum. So this is a conversion for days of the week. Sunday, think of that as non-day. Monday is one day. Tuesday, Tuesday. And Wednesday, Threesday. That's a 3. Thursday, Foursday. Friday, 5 day.
They almost all work.
I know, it's lovely, isn't it? It's lovely how they work so nicely. Saturday, 6 a day. And that's going to be a 6. So now when I'm doing this calculation, it is just a sum. It just works out nicely. And then I convert it back to the day. The last thing I do is convert it back to a day of the week. And then you give that answer. Now, if you wanted to really show off, you could do any century as well. I'll really quickly show you how to do a century. I've shown you how to do the 21st century, so the 2000s, because I said that the Doomsday in 2000 was a Tuesday. What about if you wanted to do someone's birth dates and they're born in the 1900s? I'll show you how to do that as well. It's really simple, actually. Doomsday in 2000 was a Tuesday. 1900, it was a Wednesday. This is just something you remember. If you really want to show off, you could do the 1800s. Doomsday was a Friday. And if you want to go back to the 1700s, Doomsday was a Sunday. So if you want to do one of those centuries, do the same calculation, but you would start from those positions. And if you want to do the future, that pattern repeats. So I've got a pattern here, Sunday, Friday, Wednesday, Tuesday, and it keeps going. So the 2100s, that starts with a Sunday, and then it would be a Friday, Wednesday, Tuesday, and so on. So you can do any century, finally doing the year, because that's quite hard. We did an example there, which was 2020, and that was relatively easy because 2020, the 20 was quite a small number. Now, if it's a bigger number, it gets quite hard. So imagine if I am doing a date like 90, we started with 1976, and I've got to go, okay, I've got 1976, and then I've got to work out the leap years of 1976, and then I've got to add them together and take away the sevens. Okay, So I'm going to show you some shortcuts for the year as well. Do you know there's only 28 calendars and then the pattern repeats every 28 years? Here are some key years to remember. Zero is a zero, but 28 is a zero as well because the pattern starts again. 56 is a zero because the pattern starts again, and 84 is a zero because the pattern starts again. So if you gave me a date, say 1988, what I wouldn't do is think, oh, now I have to start at 1900, add 88 years and add the leap years, and that's going to be quite hard. What I'm going to do instead is think, okay, 1900 starts with a Wednesday. I know 84 is a zero year. So then I just start from 84 and add on four more years. So then I add on four, add one leap year, and I know that that's going to be a five. So I add on 5 days after Wednesday. So that's all I would have to do. And also,
which is what? Which is?
And this is why we need those numbers as well. Wednesday is a three, plus five is an eight. Sevens disappear, so it's a one. It becomes Monday. That's why those numbers suddenly become useful, because you stopped there, didn't you? You went, okay, Wednesday plus a five is... And that's why those numbers suddenly become useful. Conway broke it up a little bit more. He broke it up like this way. Zero, he started with. 12, 24, 36, 48, 60, 72, 84, 96. If you notice, they're multiples of 12. And he remembered that zero is a zero. 12 is a one. 24 is a two. 36 is a three. 48 is a four. 60 is a five. 72 is a six. 84 is a seven, and 96 is an eight. So he memorized that. And that kind of breaks up the century a bit more. So when I did the calculation for Brady at the beginning, it was, what was it, 18th of June, 1976. What I didn't do is go, oh, 1976. Oh, that's a hard calculation. I knew 72 was a six, and I started there. That's a six plus 4 years is now a 10. Plus a leap year is an 11, plus the century is a 3, so now I've got a 14. Oh, 14 disappears. Oh, I was really pleased. Suddenly disappears, suddenly becomes a 0 again. And then we went and did the Doomsday method on the 18th of June. So the closest special date is 6th of June. And then I go, oh, well, I know the 6th of June is a 0, because that's my Doomsday calculation. And I added on 12 more days. So I got a 12. I knew I could ignore the sevens. I went, oh, the answer is five. And the last step is going, oh, if the answer is five, I convert that into a Friday. And I can say Friday.
It's my birthday.
Oh, is it your birthday? You see, I could have prepped this, but no, this was live. I actually did it.
Nice.
Yeah. Phew, it's a bit number wang.
Well, this is appropriate and a lovely coincidence. I'm building a perpetual calendar. It's the latest box of genius to arrive from KiwiCo. Everything I need is already in the box and comes with instructions that are not only clear, but they're filled with these little extra bits of knowledge. The subscription crates are just a great way to dive into science and technology, engineering, the arts and mathematics. Nothing gives you a better feel for how things work, how the world works, than doing the building yourself. I've been sending monthly crates to my nephew down in Australia, as you've probably seen before, but let's be honest, these are great for people of all ages. You can get 50% off your first box by using our URL kiwico.com/numberphile. It's there on screen and in the description if you want to go and have a click. Do it for yourself or do it for the young learners in your life. Don't waste another day. See what I did there with the wasting a day thing?
If someone says, oh, you're coming to my birthday, when is it? Right, 18th of June. And then you go, am I free? Yes, it's a Wednesday, I am free on that day. Genuinely, I think there is something you could do with this, but also you can show off at nerdy parties.
Do you ever use this though? Wouldn't you just check your calendar on your phone?
Yeah, that's not the fun though. That's all part of the fun. Doing the calculation and showing off is all part of the fun. Of course you could check on your phone.